Greetings in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. This is again your friend and pastor, Carlo Lord. I am coming to you from the First Baptist Church of Paraiso, Panama, the Republic of Panama. This morning I want to invite you to turn your Bibles to 1 Peter. 1 Peter, the 2nd chapter and the 9th verse, reads as follows. But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who had called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Father, we thank you for this another day. Bless my listeners, Lord, and help us again to be doers of the word and not only hearers. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Friends, as Christian, we need to know who we are in the Lord Jesus Christ. If we are Christian, we need to get rid of all negative thoughts about who we are in Christ. The moment you discover yourself and your ability in Christ, your worth comes back, your value comes back, and there is no man on this earth that can devalue it. Who we are? One, a chosen people. Two, a royal priesthood. Three, a holy nation. Four, God's special possession. Five, a people that is called from darkness to light. 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 9. The greatest discovery that anyone could ever make in life is to discover, my friends, who they are. Who they are. That's the greatest discovery that you could ever come across. It will make a big difference in your life. Listen, you could be born again, spirit-filled, sanctified, be a pastor or an evangelist, or even a bishop, a priest, or even the founder of a church, and yet do not know who you are in the Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, the question this morning, my friend, is who are you and what is your identity in the Lord Jesus Christ? Listen to me carefully, beloved. The devil will try to keep you ignorant of your identity in Christ. Remember what he said to Jesus? Three times he came to Jesus in a temptation of, if you are the Son of God. You remember that? If you are the Son of God, do this and do that and do... Hey, Christ knew exactly who he was. Now listen, if you ignore your identity in Christ, you will fall easily into the devil's trap. It is very important, therefore, to know who we are in Christ. If you do not know who you are in Christ, notice I'm emphasizing this, beloved, because it is important. If you do not know who you are in Christ, other people or even other situation may tell you who you are not. Sometimes when we are facing problems and difficulties, the devil comes along and try to make us believe that we are going through such things because we are not with God or God is not with us. My friends, don't you ever believe such a lie. Don't you ever believe that. As Christian, we need to know who we are and be always ready to reject negative thoughts and evil voices. We have been given the power to be what? Called sons of God. St. John chapter 1 and verse 12. We have been, you know, to those who believe, God has given us the power, the authority, if I can put it that way, to become the sons of God. That's who we are. If you have given your life to Jesus this morning, my friends, you are a child of God. I call your remembrance to 2 Kings chapter 1 and verses 10 and 12. Elijah used the power and the authority of God to call down fire from heaven to destroy the soldiers. And this was because Elijah knew exactly who he was. He knew, beloved, who he was. We need to know who we are in the Lord Jesus Christ. Many of us as Christians do not know who we are. And that's where Satan comes in and make a havoc of our lives. Don't let it happen, beloved. That's why we need to be grounded in the Word of God and to apply to every situation and issue that we face in life today. Remember what Jesus asked his disciples one day? Who do men say that I am? It's not that Jesus was doubting his identity, beloved. It's not that Jesus did not know who he was. But he wanted to be sure that his disciples knew who he was. We today, we need to know who Christ really is, who God is to us and in us. It's the only way, my beloved brothers and sisters, we are going to live that life that Christ wants us to live. Let me give you some other reasons why we need to know who we are in Christ. One, to have a strong foundation to build our life. Two, to have a great revelation of the power of God. Three, to help us live the life God intended for us to live. Four, to help us build strong faith in God. And five, which might be the most, might be the best one of all, I don't know, beloved, to remove fear of the future. Hey, do you fear the future? Then get into Christ and allow Christ to come into you. Then know who you are in Christ, and all fears will be removed. The songwriter said, I don't know about tomorrow, but I know who holds my hand. My God, this is wonderful. Friends, in conclusion this morning, to discover who you are, you must be born again. Then ask God to reveal to you who you are in Christ. Do not compare yourself to others. You know, we love comparing ourselves to others. I am not like John. I am not like Mary. Hey, stop it. Stop it. Do not compare yourself with others. You are a special person to God. You, not the person beside you, in front of you, behind you, etc. You are important to God. Now listen, number four, watch your tongue and what you say about yourself. Always think positive. Do not engage in negative thoughts. Keep away from negative and destructive influences, beloved. There are people that have nothing good to tell you. There are people that will try to mislead you. Hey, don't listen to them. Listen to the voice of God. And then, of course, please give yourself to Jesus this morning. In Jesus' name, I trust that you will do so. My friends, God bless you. Until next time, God be with you.
Jesus, you're the center of my joy. All that's good and perfect comes from you. You're the heart of my contentment, hope for all I do. Jesus, you're the center of my joy. Oh, help me sing.
Jesus, you're the center of
my joy.
Oh, oh,
said it comes from you. Yes, it does. Yes, it does.
You're the heart,
hope for all
I do.
What's his name?
Jesus.
You're
the center of my joy.
Oh, when I lost my direction, you're the compass for my way. Fire and light when nights are long and cold. In sadness, you are the laughter that shatters all my fears. When I'm all alone, your hand is there to things in life. You're the music in the meadows and the streams, the voices of the children, my family and my home. You're the source and finesse of my heart.
You're the heart of my contentment.
Oh, yeah.